ప్రసవాణి విజయవాడ కేంద్రం. మరికొద్ది క్షణాల్లో ఆంగ్లంలో వార్తలు ఢిల్లీ కేంద్రం నుంచి రిలే.
This is All India Radio, the news read by Subhadra Ramachandran. In Jharkhand, campaigning for the fourth phase of assembly elections will end this evening. In this phase, voting would be held on Monday in 15 constituencies, split over 4 districts of Dhanbad, Devghar, Giridih, and Bokaro. Our correspondent reports the campaigning has been intensified as political leaders are making last-ditch efforts to woo the voters. Some campaigners and senior leaders of all political parties are to hold series of public meetings and rallies. In Naxal-affected 5 assembly segments of Gogodha, Jamua, Giridih, Dumri and Tumri, campaigning would end at 3 p.m., while in the rest of 10 seats, canvassing would continue till 5 p.m. In Uttar Pradesh, the first meeting of National Rejuvenation Protection and Management of River Gunga Council will be held at Kanpur today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will chair the meeting. In a tweet, the PMO said that during the meeting, Mr. Modi will review progress of work and deliberate on aspects of cleaning the Ganga. Chief Minister Uttarakhand Tirendra Singh Rawat will also attend the meeting. Prime Minister Narendra Modi reiterated India's commitment to support the government of the Maldives for a strong, democratic, prosperous and peaceful Maldives. Interacting with Foreign Minister of Maldives, Abdullah Shahid, who called on him in New Delhi yesterday, Mr. Modi conveyed his compliments on the achievement of President Ibrahim Mohamed Solih in his first year. He noted the satisfaction, the announced level of engagement between India and Maldives, and the positive outcomes of bilateral cooperation during the last 1 year. The Maldivian Foreign Minister thanked Mr. Modi for his vision and strong leadership in driving the India-Maldives relationship. Mr. Shahid is in India for the 6th India-Maldives Joint Commission meeting, which was held in New Delhi yesterday. 3 MOUs were signed and exchanged after the meeting. India and Indonesia have resolved to strengthen cooperation in areas of defense and security, connectivity and trade during talks between External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar and his Indonesian counterpart, Retno Marsudi, in New Delhi yesterday. The two sides reviewed the entire gamut of ties at the 6th India-Indonesia Joint Commission meeting. The External Affairs Ministry in a statement said that during the meeting, both sides reiterated their commitment to strengthen ties in the areas including people-to-people exchanges. As key partners in the Indo-Pacific, both sides call for greater synergy in the region, guided by the shared vision on maritime cooperation. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh chaired a meeting of the Consultative Committee of Parliament for the Ministry of Defence in New Delhi yesterday. The subject of the meeting was Border Roads Organisation, BRO. Director General BRO Lieutenant General Harpal Singh gave a detailed presentation on the working of the organisation, especially on maintaining operational road infrastructure for the armed forces in border areas. The ministry said in a statement the defense minister lauded the efforts of BRO in building border infrastructure and contributing to the improvement of lives of people residing in the border areas. It said during the course of discussion that there were valuable suggestions which defense minister appreciated. A special court in Mumbai has refused to cancel non-bailable warrant issued against fugitive diamond merchant Mehul Choksi, a key accused in the alleged Punjab National Bank scam. Choksi had moved the court in June last year seeking cancellation of the warrant, which the court issued for not responding to the summons and participate in the probe. Last week, the court had rejected a similar plea by Choksi in the PNB scam case, registered by the ED under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act. Choksi and his nephew, Nirav Modi, in connivance with some bank officials, allegedly drew PNB of 14,000 crore rupees by obtaining letters of undertaking fraudulently. Assam Director General of Police Bhaskar Jyoti Mahanta has said that the situation in the state is under control. Talking to AIR correspondent last night, he said that additional forces have been deployed to control the law and order situation. Mr. Mahanta said that over 1,000 people were detained yesterday, out of which 65 were arrested for their alleged involvement in violent protests. The DGP has appealed the agitators to be careful so that those elements do not hijack the situation. Mr. Mahanta said that police will not allow the situation to go out of hand. The coal minister said that it is considering a lot of 6 coal mines that have been marked for end users like power, iron and steel and sale of coal. And that is the end of his news bulletin.
ఆకాశవాణి విజయవాడ కేంద్రం.